Okay, well, it's 10:31. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Open Forum. We have some very special guests today. As you guys know, we mentioned we announced the opening of the lecture series last week, and we have Jason and Michelle here from AmeriFirst and AmeriUno. Hi, guys. And they'll be presenting our first in the series of the lectures. And I'll go ahead and introduce them right now. Go ahead, guys.
Thanks, Ryan. Yeah, so basically we're gonna do a 6-week series of just different lectures that we've had internally with our office that we've shared with a lot of our realtor teams that have been influential and are obviously relevant. With this one, it's basically, we did it in the fall, and it's gonna touch on just the way the environment was with COVID. And obviously, as we are getting past COVID, a lot of the people that were working from home, or, you know, as evidence of the Zoom call, are still working from home. It's just an environment now that people have gotten used to, and the market is booming, obviously, the real estate market. And it doesn't seem like it's going to change anytime soon. And how we interact with customers and clients and you know, people like that, it's going to be the same landscape going forward. And this will show you how to communicate properly with those potential clients and just the changing market with technology and such. Mm-hmm. So Ryan, if you can share the screen or allow us capability of sharing our screen, that's how we can display it.
I will make you the host. please remember to make me the host back. All right, guys.
The host, all right. Right. Go ahead and play it.
Okay, so we're going to talk about this. Yes, how do we disrupt-proof our business? And so I'm just going to get into it. And here's the good news, guys. How many of you would like an instant free bonus just for showing up? Would you like a copy of the slides? Just type in a yes. And let me just hear, how many people want a copy of the slides? Yes, you're gonna get them. That way you don't have to take crazy notes and like you're gonna forget a half of what you see. Okay, cool. Heather says a hoorah. I like that, Heather, appreciate it. Okay, we're gonna go fast. And like I said, you're gonna get a copy of the slides so you can go back to a lot of what we talk about here. As mentioned, my brand new book came out earlier this year, Disrupt or Die, How to Survive and Thrive the Digital Real Estate Shift. If you are a real estate agent and you don't yet have a copy, get with the loan officer who invited you here. Okay. We're making free copies available through the loan officer who invited you because we want to help you guys succeed and survive and thrive in this digital real estate shift. The book is the start of that. Today's conversation is the start of that. And we have lots of other things planned for you guys in the coming weeks and months as well. So that's that. If you want to buy a bunch of copies, hey, you can go to getdisruptordie.com or go to Amazon, whatever you prefer to do. Okay. Let's talk about our agenda here. Number one, we're going to go real quickly through the 5 trends driving the digital real estate shift. And then we're going to unpack, like, how do we get tactical with this, right? How do we actually make that pivot and disrupt-proof our business? And I'm going to focus today on digital domination for the win. Because let's face it, that's where the customer attention is. And that's where we need to be as well. And then the other segment we'll cover is, how do we have a plan to actually achieve our goals? I know some of you had recently put together your business plan, you know, your volume and units goal for 2021. I think that's awesome. But look, it all comes down to, in this business, how many of you would agree that it's all about conversations? Like, the name of the game is conversations. And the more meaningful business-focused conversations you can have, right, the more likely you're going to achieve your goals. Anybody agree with that? What does James Brown say? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Right. So James Brown agrees, you know, we must be on the right page. Okay. Let's get into it. I also want to set the stage that, look, this is for you if you want to remain relevant, you want to expand your influence and grow your business. And I'm going to assume you're here today because you want to do that. And you are willing to put in. What is it? What is it? Does anybody know? It's a four-letter word, the work, right? Work. Building a real estate business isn't easy, right? Becoming a brand that people recognize and trust and follow and refer isn't easy. It takes time. It takes effort. It takes discipline. It takes execution. And it takes learning new skills. And that's why you're here today. I applaud you so much for being here today. So if you are down with that program, right? You're on board. Let's get into this and now quickly go through the five trends that are driving the digital real estate shift. By the way, these are covered in more depth in the book. So when you get the book, you can go deeper on these. But let's get started. Number one, the rise of the digital culture. All right, so quiz time. We've come a long ways, right? The evolution of consumer technology. How many of you here remember going to the bank? Remember what that was like? Anybody ever walk into a bank lately? Okay. How many of you remember an Amazon only sold books? That was quite a while ago. And of course, just recently, they've announced that they are now in the pharmaceutical business. And then, of course, how many of you remember life before Lyft and Uber? Right? Remember when you used to hail and have to get a taxi and all that kind of stuff? So, I mean, guys, this is only like Amazon and Uber, right? I mean, we're talking about the last 10 years. Today, what can we do today with technology? Look at how much it's shifted. Today, we can host an open house and use Amazon Alexa devices and actually have features of the home in each individual room recorded and placed strategically in the house as a kind of like a modern AI-driven, if you will, right? Open house with voice assistants. We can now travel virtually anywhere in the world, right? And stay at somebody else's house. And we can now send money to anybody, anywhere from the comfort of our mobile phone, right? And all this is happening simultaneously, right? Along with the second phase that's driving the digital real estate shift, which is the rise of consumer control. And how many people remember what it was like in the past? Anybody been in this business, 10 years or more, 15 years? Remember in the past, right? Agents, you guys used to be in control, right? People used to, so Heather says 20 years. Congratulations, Heather. You deserve an award. You deserve a round of applause. 20 years in this business. Give her a badge, people. All right. So agents used to be in control, right? Remember how people used to go to you, Heather, all the time? Hey, what are the listings? What's on market, right? I used to have to go through you to get to the property. Now it's completely reversed, isn't it, right? The shift has been to the consumer is now in control and it's not going away. So how many of you here who sell real estate or mortgage think that a consumer needs you to find a home or find a mortgage? Does a consumer need you to do that? No, they don't. Thank you, John. They do not. Right? That's why third-party portals like Zillow and Redfin and all these other companies exist. They don't need you to find a home, right? And they don't need you as a mortgage professional to quote rates. Now, I'm not saying is it accurate or not what they find online and so forth, but I'm saying we know that they're going online first, right? To do their research and to get educated. So you're not in control anymore. The consumer's in control. And the third shift driving the digital real estate shift is the rise of mobile, right? Look at the growth in mobile apps. It's just blown up. 2019, last year, 204 billion downloads in mobile apps. Okay, we're going to talk about mobile as well. Look at the stats. Website traffic, 52% is from a mobile device. Social media, 80% from mobile. Watching videos, 50% from mobile. So what's the lesson here? The lesson here is this is what's your user experience like? What's your consumer experience? Is it mobile first? Like, I would suggest that you audit your online presence. And we're going to talk about that a couple examples in just a moment. But is it ideal? Is it optimized for mobile? Because if it's not, if it's broken, if there's a bunch of friction in there and you're losing people because it's too cumbersome, you're fading away and you're losing attention because consumers have evolved. Have we kept pace with that is the real question. Look at this. According to the NAR, right? You guys have heard of them, I hope, right? 70% of them, of buyers, found their home on a mobile device. Found their home. How? By searching, by going to the portals, right? By getting, subscribing to the IDX listing updates and all that kind of stuff, right? found it on a mobile device. How about your website? Have you looked at your mobile, at your website from a mobile phone yet? Have you tried contacting yourself from your website on a mobile device? Maybe have somebody in your family, a friend or relative, do it. Test it out. Somebody who doesn't have that realtor hat on that like you do, or that lender hat. But this is important stuff, because are people judging you by the first point of awareness or engagement they have with you online? Are they making a determination about who they think you are by how easy it is or not to engage with you, starting with online? They are. You guys know they are. Number four trend is the rise of social media. Obviously, we don't have to spend a lot of time here, but look at the huge growth since 2004, right? This is monthly active users, okay? And you can see Facebook and YouTube are the two big players, okay? Facebook with over 2 billion monthly active users, and YouTube just under that. So this is where consumer attention is. Is this where you are? Or are you still kind of wishing it was like it was back in the old days, right? And there's some things I wish it was like as well back in the old days, but guess what? It's not, okay? The fifth trend driving the digital real estate shift is the rise of the disruptors. Now, depending on where you are in the country, if you're like in the Arizona area, if you're in Florida, I believe, in Texas, in certain parts, there's people. How many of you here have like the iBuyers in your markets? Opendoor, OfferPad, Zillow, right? All these other iBuyer versions that have come out there. Does anybody have those? Go ahead, use your chat right now. Type it in. When you hear that noise, you know that's your time to chat it in, to type in your chat. Let's see here. Who do we got? Who's got iBuyers out there? John does. Margie does. Too expensive in your area, Heather. Okay, great. So they don't. They're not in the sweet spot for price points there. Gregory, no. Okay. Daphne, yes. Tracy, oh yes. Yeah. So we don't know what the future of that's going to look like. It's constantly evolving. But here's the other disruption that's happening is, right, the battlefield for the consumer mindshare, right? These real estate companies that are now tech companies, these tech companies that are now lenders, right? And so on and so forth. There's a lot of confusion and fragmentation for consumers. And that, by the way, is a clue and a hint for you as to how you can be valuable and disrupt-proof your business is by helping people make sense of it all, make sense of the chaos, okay? All right, now what's come along here is a new disruptor, COVID-19. And we're still working our way through COVID-19, right? We don't know where this is gonna end up yet, but we do know that it's already had huge implications to the real estate industry. Let's take a look at some of the examples here, okay? According to Zillow, during the pandemic, 43% of people they surveyed said they're more likely to sell a home entirely online. After the pandemic, those same people, 33% of them still would sell a home entirely online. I'm going to throw some stats at you first, and then we're going to get very specific and tactical of how you adjust and make the pivot to be relevant today. Look at Redfin, right? This is, as of June of this year, nearly half of recent home buyers made an offer sight unseen. Is anybody experiencing this yourselves? How many of you here have already sold a house sight unseen to a buyer who never actually walked through the house? Has anybody here done that yet? Timothy, contract today. Hey, congratulations, Timothy. Hey, let's make sure we get Timothy a book. Yes. Woo.
Congratulations. You are a winner.
Timothy, contract today. Somebody make sure I get Timothy Zumigala. Help me pronounce that. get Timothy's contact information. We'll make sure we get him a copy of a book. Okay, who else we got here? Put in an offer and saw it afterwards. Okay, cool. Brian, several times. Tracy did a couple of years ago. And Bing Bing Lee as well. She sold a home sight unseen. All right, let's continue on. How about in-person versus virtual tour, right? 33% chose virtual or video tour versus in-person, okay? 33% of consumers said they won't be comfortable going out in public in the near future and prefer a contactless option to do business. Now, will that change? Probably. And is that the majority of people? No, right? But let's just face it. Would you agree that COVID has changed the expectations of consumers? And how they want to engage with people, particularly for real estate? How many of you here would agree that COVID has accelerated the expectation of things like virtual tours, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, Ruth says absolutely. Heather says, yes, sir. Agreed. Okay. Redfin. Views of virtual 3D walkthroughs on redfin.com surged over 200% since February. I'm sharing all this data with you for a reason, right? And by the way, Google released some data that said their search queries for virtual home tours or 360 home tours up 400% over last year. By the way, that's a little keyword research insight for you there. If you are wondering, hey, how do I immediately show up and differentiate myself from my competition who hasn't pivoted? Well, maybe you want to consider putting virtual or tours, virtual open houses at the top of your list of services provided for sellers. I wonder if that could be a point of differentiation for you right out of the gate. Yes, thank you, Margie. Margie says, nice. Nice for you too, is Margie. Guys, so sometimes it's very simple because I know if I asked realtors, right? Hey, oh, do you do virtual tour? Well, sure I do. But where is it on their, promotion calendar? Where is it in their branding? Where is it on their list of services? Do they talk about it? Have you done a video that says, hey, in light of the new normal, right? Now all my listings come with a virtual tour and a 360 home tour with them. That's one of the ways we're pivoting and adding more value to our clients in today's world. Could you do something like that? Would that be simple? So according to Google's numbers, right? That was, by the way, 15 million consumer leads that searched for those terms. I don't know if that's just domestic or international, but the point is there's a lot of people Googling those terms. So what does that tell you? Well, what do we know about Google? When people search for stuff, what does that mean? It means they're looking for it, right? It means that is an indication of what people are seeking, right? So if you can bring that to the surface and enter the conversation that's already happening in a lot of consumers' minds, you get noticed, okay? All right. This is from the NAR 2020 Trends Report, and this is what the survey respondents found most helpful tech in buying a home. Number one, virtual tours, right? Accurate and detailed listing information. Accurate and detailed neighborhood information, high quality listing photos, ability to do a walkthrough via video chat. That's 40% of people. How many of you here have already started doing buyer consults over Zoom, seller consults over Zoom, reviewing appraisals over Zoom, inspection reports? Has anybody started offering that? Has anybody here heard this from your prospects and clients? Do we really need to get together face-to-face? Can't we just do this over Zoom? Let's see. I've got some answers coming in. Ruth does it often. Margie says, yep. Thank you for your participation, by the way. I appreciate it a lot. So guys, it's already happening, right? So those are some of the stats, and I share those with you. I share the digital shift thing with you because sometimes people are still, like I said, romantic about the past. And that's okay, but you just want to make sure that you are staying current and not fading away, right? You ever heard the term fading winner? So a fading winner is somebody who's really good with clients like you. You've been around a long time in the business. You care a lot and you do a really great job, but you haven't adapted yet to a modern consumer. And therefore you may still be winning, but you're fading away from consumer attention. And as each year goes by, right, the distance grows larger. The gap, the fading away increases. So I'm here today, AmeriFirst and the loan officers who care about you invited you here today because they want to help you make that shift. They want to help you disrupt-proof your business. Who's ready to learn how to do that? Can I get a witness? Yes, type it in. Let's go. Let's get on this train now and learn how to disrupt-proof our business. Bing Bing says, oh yeah, let's go. Okay. First and foremost, let me set the stage. Anybody heard of Charles Darwin? Yeah, guy's known for a few things, right? Here's the interesting thing about his quote. Remember survival of the fittest? Well, the truth is, the quote is, it's in the struggle for survival, the fittest win because they succeed in not by being stronger, but by adapting themselves to their environment. So the name of the game in surviving and thriving the digital real estate shift is not being stronger or faster or better. Like Susan says, the dinosaurs, they died. Well, yeah, I mean, there was, I think, a meteor or whatever that crashed and like killed them. But the point is that if you're going to survive, the key to survival is your ability to adapt and change and learn new skills. And that's why you're here, okay? Let me give you a couple of examples of adaptable agents. Here's my friend Kenny Klaus in Arizona. When iBuyers came into Arizona in a huge way, and I think the last stat I remember was iBuyers had like 6% of the market in his county in Arizona, right? That's where they really established a stronghold. What did Kenny do? Did he put his head in the sand and say, gee, I wish they weren't here? Did he get angry? Did he get like, that's not fair? No, he decided to pivot and actually involve iBuyers as a fiduciary, as a consultant, as a trusted advisor. He said, hey, you considering about using an iBuyer? Cool, let's take a look at their offer. So what he did was line up all the potential offers for sellers, right? Side by side in a comparison, he was the trusted advisor and allowed the client to make the best decision for themselves. And if you look at the stat down here, in 2019, 32% of his transactions had an iBuyer as a buyer or seller. Now, what? Imagine had he put his head in the sand and said no or badmouthed them and screw that, they overcharge you, they, you know, et cetera, et cetera. Do consumers respond to that? No. They want choices. We've already established consumers are in control. So you can either decide to, right, figure out how to pivot or be a fading winner, right? Here's Erin Kruger. She is out of Nashville, and much to what you guys have just proven for me here, Nashville-based agent Erin Kruger said her team has sold 10 homes sight unseen during our shelter in place the first couple quarters of this year, which is twice as many in all of last year. So again, COVID's another disruptor. It has shifted consumer behavior, okay? So when we're talking about disrupt-proofing your business and digital domination for the win, here's where we're going to roll up our sleeves and get tactical right now. There's three areas that we're going to focus on, okay? Number one is search, number two is social, and number three is paid traffic. That would be like paid ads, Google, Facebook, Instagram ads, and things like that. And I'm going to walk through some tactics and strategies for you right now of how you can begin to dominate on digital in the coming year so you achieve your business goals that you set out. All right. First and foremost, let's start with search. Why are we starting with search? Who else starts with search when they begin with real estate? Even if they got a referral, if somebody gets referred to you, right? Margie says everyone does. Yes. Congratulations, Margie. Another book, Margie. Let's get Margie's contact information. Margie Donaldson. So if Margie, if your loan officer from AmeriFirst is here, get with them and say, I want my book. All right. So consumers start with search. Yes. Even if I get a referral to Margie and write, you know, Uncle Bob says, hey, you got to call Margie. She's the best agent in town. Cool. I'm going to get on my phone. I'm going to Google Margie Donaldson. Let's see what comes up. Okay. I want you to Google your name. And I want you to see what comes up for yourself. I'm going to show you a couple examples in a second here. But the key for search is we want to control the first impression the client has. First impressions are everything. You never get a second chance, right? Cliches, but they're true. Now, let me give you a couple examples. Here is a real estate agent up in Canada, Sandra Pike. And this is if I Googled Sandra Pike's name from my desktop, not my mobile. This is a desktop version. If I Googled her name, and you can try this yourselves, play at home, not right now, later today. Okay, stay with us here. If you Google Sandra Pike, this is what you're going to see. Now, take your realtor hat on off right now and take your lender hat off. All right. I want you to reach on top of your head, grab that hat you're wearing. I want you to take it off and set it aside. From here on out, you are a consumer. You are not a lender. You're not a real estate agent. You're a prospective buyer or seller. And you're looking, you heard about Sandra Pike. So you're going to type in Sandra Pike's name and voila, all of a sudden, this is what comes up on your head. And what do you notice right here, right? Right here in this section right here.
Good. How are you doing?
She's dominating, right? Obviously, you put in her name, but look at how structured it is. Meet the team, listings coming soon, our listing.
Gretchen in the room.
And by the way, what do you see over here on the right side? What's your eye drawn to over here, perhaps? Does anybody know?
I do.
What are you looking for over here on this right section of the screen? Five stars. Margie Donaldson says, Margie's just rocking it today. Way to go, Margie. James Brown for you. Okay. She's got 89 Google reviews. This isn't a class on Google reviews, although we have that available. So if you want that, get with your AmeriFirst loan officer. Okay. But do people make a judgment based on online reviews? Is that the currency of trust today? Timothy says reviews. Heather says stars. 100%. Okay. So we're on the same page with that. Now, here's an agent that I personally know here in Las Vegas where I live. And I typed in her name. And here's the thing I know about her. I know she's a successful agent. But the consumer doesn't know that. So I figured, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to play around and see, okay, what if I type in Carol's name and what do I get? How many of you notice a difference already? Number one, right, there isn't the structure of the layout on the left side of the screen over here with, you know, very organized, et cetera. There is the links, obviously, to her site. You can see one review. But over here, I don't see any reviews. And our consumers today, I'll restate the question. Are they conditioned to look for reviews to evaluate a business? How many of you look at reviews when you're evaluating a vendor, a business, right? A pool contractor or whatever it is, right? Everybody does. Everybody does. So even though this agent is good and successful, guess what? She's a fading winner. Because in a moment, somebody might make the judgment that, again, they don't know Carol like I know her, but the presence compared to this? Which one do you personally feel more drawn to? You know, we got the picture over here. Let me see if she's got this here. Good thing is she's got some photos. She's got the map integration and stuff like that. So she's got a good start, but fading away. Okay. So here's what we're talking about. Google My Business. Control the first impression. I'm going to give you guys some homework assignments through today's session. I want you to Google your business name and optimize your profile and get Google verified. What is that? What am I talking about here? If you haven't yet taken ownership of your Google My Business listing, you need to. I've done this exercise all across the country with agents and lenders, and a lot of people don't realize that you already have a Google My Business listing in most cases because you're a company, okay? So if you're a real estate agent, Google your business name, whether if that's like, you know, Sandy Smith, Remax, you know, whatever it is, the name of your business, your brokerage, et cetera, Google that and see what comes up. And some people are like, well, I didn't even realize I had one. Yes. Cause Google, what they do is they scour their web, they grab it and they're going to create a business listing for you. Google My Business is all about local, local, local. Okay. So the link down here, Google My Business, I'm sorry, google.com/business. That's where you're going to want to go. Remember, you're going to get these slides. Okay. Now here's your homework. Google your business. What do you see? Set up and optimize your Google My Business listing. You're going to need to complete a profile and Google's going to need to get this, send you a postcard. That's right. Because they want to verify you're a local business. Because what they're trying to do with that is serve up local content for the people that are searching for businesses near them. Okay. And then I want you to start building out your reviews. Get 5 reviews from past clients. How do you do that? Here's a couple ideas. Run a contest. You know, I was working with these 2 real estate agents in, I forget where it was anyway. What they were doing is going on social media. And they were running a monthly contest. So they would go live on social media, these 2 wonderful ladies, and they would say, hey, have you worked with us in the past? Did you, you know, do a transaction with us, et cetera, et cetera? If you've not left us a review or testimonial yet, we're running a contest. So go to this link here, and they provide the link to their Google My Business page, and they say, we'd appreciate it if you leave a review. And what they do is they enter those people in a drawing every single month, and they give away, at that time, it was a free dinner, like a good dinner, like a Roots Chris Steakhouse or Morton's or something like that, right? A couple $100 or so you invest in that. And they got these referral reviews monthly. And what they do is they go back on social media and they choose the winner. So it gives them 2 opportunities to get on social and build their awareness. So that's one way how you get reviews from past clients that you've closed. Okay. And by the way, the thing that I also do is like I work with lenders and realtors. I have each other cross review each of you. If you've done a transaction together, go ahead and leave a review for each of you, right? You got a loan officer here, loan officer, leave a review for your agent. Agent, leave a review for your loan officer. Okay. You guys have done business together. Okay. So remember, search was first. Second is social. Now we're going to talk about social. Stay with me, gang. It's about to get faster. You better buckle up. Are you guys ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Okay, let's go. Social. The key with social is content development and distribution. What I mean by that is, obviously, you've got to show up, you've got to produce and share content, but you've got to engage and comment. Again, you'll see some examples in just a moment. Engage and comment. No posting ghost. Anybody know what I mean by posting ghost? Who here knows what I mean by that? What is posting ghost? Type in your answers now. Post and ghost. What could Geoff mean by post and ghost? I'll take post and post for 200, Geoff. Yeah, Ruth says post and never follow up. Love that, Ruth. Congratulations. Yeah, Gregory says the same thing. Post to someone's page, never follow up. Post, not reply to comments, interactions. Awesome, Josh. Good one.
Congratulations.
Josh,
you are a winner.
I don't know if Josh, if you're a lender or a realtor, but either way, you get a free book. See, prizes for participating people. Okay, so you guys are all on the right track here. Posting ghosts is you post and then you leave and you don't ever engage and comment back with each other. There's all kinds of magic that happens behind the scenes when you comment, engage, and like, okay, algorithm-wise, okay? People don't follow ghosts, right? Somebody here said, Heather says secret agent, yeah. You've got to connect, right? And drive the online offline. That's one of the wonderful things about online is we can leverage that to drive online engagement and connection and so forth. Okay, check this out. 93% of consumers expect you to have a social media presence. So again, I've talked to a lot of agents, lenders as well. I was on a webinar once where a lender said, you know, I've been doing this business 15 years. Why do I need to be on Facebook? I'm doing well. You know what that is? That's one of these. So it's not about, quote, Facebook. It's about just, are you where your consumers are? I don't know if it's Facebook. I don't know if it's like Instagram, LinkedIn, whatever. The point is, this is where consumer attention is, right? And that's a fading winner, okay? Let me tell you, the year, you know, if we've got a great market for real estate and all that kind of stuff, but if you're a lender, right, let's just face it, the refinance volume is going to come down. Okay. So what are you doing to stay relevant and in front of this wave of consumers that are still buying? All right. So with content and distribution, we're talking about you need to become known. Heather said it great. Secret agent. Secret agent. How many people know you even exist in your town? If you walk by 1,000 people in your town, how many of them would recognize you? Oh, hey, that's the agent. Or online, let's say, for social media. Okay. How do you become known? Right. Let me break it down for you and then you'll see some examples. To become known, you have to create a way for people to connect and engage with you, all right? Content is what you create that mobilizes your journey on the road to becoming known. I hate to break it to you. You're in a business that requires you to become known, lender and real estate agent. How do you become known? Online, content. You've got to post and share some kind of content. What else would people engage with? Let me share some examples with you. Here's my friend, Jennifer Beeston, right? She has an amazing YouTube channel and she posts, I think a video a minimum of once a week, but she's been doing it for, I don't know, a couple, 3 years or so. And she is crushing it with YouTube. Why? Because of her content. Look at her topics, VA funding fee landmines, right? A little comment about brokers, renting versus buying, fact versus fiction with VA mortgages. And look at her view count, right? Look at how fast she reaches 1,000 views, 2 days, okay? And this isn't a deep dive on YouTube class here. Guess what? How many of you think we have a YouTube class? How many would like a YouTube class? Go ahead, type in YouTube now in the comments and let's make sure you get with your AmeriFirst loan officer to learn more about a potential YouTube class in the coming year. Bing Bing says yes. Tracy says yes. Heather, Ruth, Brian. Brian, you've got a YouTube channel. Is that what you're saying? I hope so. Kathy, Carolyn, so we're getting out a lot of yeses here. Somebody take notes and remind me. They're expecting a YouTube class. Okay, hey, lenders, real estate agents. How about my friend Karen Carr, right? Anybody heard of Karen Carr? She's pretty big in the real estate training space now, but she also has a business, which is Georgia Coast Homes Team. And I actually interviewed Karen. She's actually in the book, Disrupt or Die. She gave me a nice testimonial here as well. But Karen has built a very successful business on YouTube where she gets, I think when the last I saw, was it 70% of her business is coming from YouTube. She gets, I think, about 3 to 5 calls. Hello, telephone calls per week from her YouTube content. Would anybody like 3 to 5 calls per week that sounds something like this? Hi, this is Bill Smith, and we've been watching your YouTube videos for 3 months now, and we feel like we know you. You're just really great. You got a great personality. We really feel like we'd like to work with you as a real estate agent. So could we schedule a time to talk about buying or selling? How many of you here want calls like that? Okay. That's not a lead, right? That is called a come list me. Okay. That's what that is. And lenders, you could do the same thing. So again, remember, I talked about content distribution as a way to engage with you. This is how people engage with you today online, right? Why not go where they're at? Let me give you a couple of ideas, more ideas. Anybody here on Instagram? Anybody Instagram vibe? What's your go-to channel? My Instagram people, you'll like this. And by the way, this is an idea you can take and implement now because we're not even in December yet, okay? So we got Sami is on Instagram. Kathy's on Instagram. Bing Bing Instagram. Jessica. Okay. All right. So this is the 12 days of Christmas. And this is my friend, Realty Billings, Montana. And what they've decided to do to create engagement and awareness on their Instagram feed is to run the 12 days of Christmas giveaway, something that makes sense. So what do? It begins December 12th. You want to do this? Time to get in action. Okay. Let me show you what this looks like. This is one of their posts, obviously. And by the way, make a note, go follow Realty Billings on Instagram. That's one of the way you learn how to do things on social media is you follow other people doing cool stuff, right? So this is their process for participating in the 12 Days of Christmas giveaway. Here's what you have to do. Number one, on Instagram, you have to like the Realty Billings Amber Urin Real Estate Facebook page. Sorry, Facebook page. You have to also follow them on Instagram. You have to like and share this post right here, that post, and make sure it's set to public so their team can see it, and you have to tag 2 friends. The reality is, people, how long do you think that takes, the average person? Probably 3 minutes, okay? So there are 4 specific steps there, but there's some intention as to why they're asking people to do that. Now, why would people do that? Well, look at some of the gifts they give away, all right? This is a touchscreen air fryer on day 1. Day 7 is a Dyson vacuum cleaner. Okay. Day 9 is a KitchenAid food mixer. Looks like there's a TV in there too. So they're not giving the cheap gifts away, right? They're like playing all out on this thing. But can you imagine the engagement, the awareness, and the growth of their followers that they're going to get over these 12 days of Christmas? It's going to be pretty epic, okay? And it's not the first time they've done this, by the way. Here's another example. How many of you here like to support local businesses? Anybody love supporting local businesses, especially during these challenging times, COVID, right? All right, here's this real estate team. Jessica says yes, John, yes. These guys are in Spokane, Washington. So look at this. In honor of our 1,000th post, we're gifting $1,000 in gift cards to our favorite local businesses. For your chance to win a $100 gift card, so it's 10 gift cards of 100 each, right? What do you got to do? Follow them on social, like and tag as many people as you'd like who also want to win up to 1,000 local gift cards. Share this post on your story. So do you see there's a bit of an art and a science between leveraging a giveaway like these examples to actually grow your following? You've got to be intentional with it. And if you're giving away good things, people don't mind supporting that, right? Who wouldn't mind getting behind this? Okay. Here's another example of a post for them. We're only about 6 feet away. Just know we're here for you, Spokane. Stay safe, stay healthy. You guys could do this in your local market right now. Okay. Look what it says. We're mastering Zoom client meetings, listing presentations, FaceTime walkthroughs, and genuinely loving our community. 6 feet away, of course. Right. And by the way, follow these guys. The FAR group, Northwest. Remember how I said a few minutes ago, how many of you offer virtual tours? How many of you do it? Well, here's an example of agents bringing it to the surface and using it as a point of engagement in social media content. People struggle with, well, what the heck do I post? All right, well, anybody liking these ideas so far? I need a little motivation boost. I need a little self-esteem boost. Who's liking these ideas?
Wow!
Yes. All right. Thank you, Kathy. Cool. Bing Bing says yes. Martin says yes. Love it. Love it. Love it. Great. Great. John. Oh, cool. Glad you came. Okay. You're being evaluated by your online presence. If you're not producing content, guess what? Crickets. I wish I had a cricket button. You don't exist. You're a fading winner. Okay. I got to go faster because I have a lot more content to cover, but here's your homework. That's right. Homework. And loan officer, AmeriFirst loan officer, right? You invited your agents here. If they're here, this is your chance to team up and work together, collaborate, hold each other accountable on these things. Get together a week or two from now via Zoom and go through the slides. Talk about your one big idea from here and what you're going to implement. Okay. Here's your homework. You guys ready? Type your answer into this right now. What is your primary social platform that you spend the most time on? Type it in now. Facebook. Mm-hmm. All right, so we're seeing a lot of Facebook. We're seeing Solomon with Instagram. Looks like the winner here is Facebook. And we have Ruth for the curveball with Nextdoor. Yes, way to go, Ruth. Much overlooked, but an opportunity with Nextdoor as well. Jessica's is Instagram. Okay, cool. All right, now here's your homework assignment, okay? I want you to get intentional. Because by the way, this is the only way you succeed with building relationships is getting intentional. Like relationships don't happen by accident, right? You get intentional with them, okay? 5 people per day. Here's what I want you to do. Like 5 social profiles per day. So that's 25 over 5 days, okay? I want you to follow. So it's basically boom, boom, like and follow. There's 3 seconds, okay? And I want you to pick 5 people per day and comment on their posts. They could be past clients. They could be anybody that, you know what, you think has got something that's cool, that's relevant, that was like made you laugh, whatever. Because a lot of people do the drive-by likes, right? And that's not enough. It's part of it, like, follow, but the most important thing you can do to drive your engagement is, guess what? Engage with others. Yeah. Right? So that's your homework assignment. Who here is willing to take on that homework challenge? Just put a type in a yes, and we're going to keep going. Okay? All right. Heather says yes. Solomon says, let's go. Daphne, yes, 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 yes. Awesome. Ruth does it daily. Of course you do, Ruth, because you're awesome. All right. So the last section for us to talk about here is paid traffic. We're talking about running ads on Facebook and Instagram or the Google Display Network. That's the GDN, right? So Google Display, that's when like the ads follow you around everywhere, right? From website to website, all that kind of jazz. Retargeting. This is not, a deep dive on this content. As I said before, you want to deep dive on these topics. We're going to ask you at the end, what are the topics you want to most go deeper on? And then, of course, there's YouTube ads, right? These pre-roll ads, right? These ads that show up before you watch a video. Those are growing in popularity as real estate agents begin to take on YouTube more and realize how valuable YouTube can be for you and your business. Okay, let's go. Let me show you some examples here. I think this is the best way to inspire you guys of what to do. Here is Taya DiCarlo. She's out of the Los Angeles area. And Taya was deciding to do her first ever virtual open house. So here she is. Here's her profile on Instagram. And what she decided to do to create awareness for her first virtual open house was do a, 30-second video of her announcing her open house. This is the listing. And then jumping in the pool. Obviously fully clothed, right? And then she comes up out of the water and just says, woohoo, right? I'm just, what else did you think I was gonna do to celebrate my first open house, right? So first and foremost, she's creating awareness for it, right? She's getting attention, okay? Next, what she does is she actually posts a virtual tour video on Instagram. So this is a 6-minute video. All right. And she posts that on her Instagram feed and basically has somebody following her around with a mobile phone. By the way, anybody know a young person here? Anybody know any young people? Know anybody who knows how to do this, to look at the screen, knows how to hold up a phone, press record, and just follow you? Do you think you could find somebody who could do that? It's that simple. right? This person just followed her around the house, showed off the house, do what you do best. And now she's got a 6-minute virtual open house tour of this new listing that she posts on Instagram. And look at that. This was back in April. She had almost 1800 views. It's grown since then. But she doesn't stop there. This is the paid ad strategy. This is the video. I don't know if you'll be able to hear it, but here, let me show you this. She does an Instagram story, okay? This is a minute long Instagram. Actually, this is a video. So she's got this minute long video. It's kind of her walking through the house, right? Yada-da-da-da. Yep. And she's going to use this for an Instagram story. You guys can watch this video later when you get the slides, okay? It's 1 minute. What she does, though, is she turns that 1 minute video into an Instagram story ad. You following me? So you can run ads with stories. You can run ads with video. You can run ads with images, all that kind of stuff. Her jam, I should say, is Instagram, right? Mostly. So she decides to run this ad and have some calls to action with it, et cetera. So this is a screenshot of obviously Facebook, where you would run an ad for Instagram or Facebook, okay? And these are the results, okay? With that one story ad, she reached 32,000 people. She got 10,000 views. 1,700 people clicked on the link to learn more about the property. Her cost per click was $18. All right, so let me do some quick math, guys. For you math wizards out there, I got to scroll to my calculator app here on my iPhone. Let's just do 1,700 times 0.18. So that was $300. 17 showings. Now, here's her post after it was all said and done. There was additional exposure she got from this, but look at her post on Instagram. 60,000 people saw this property featured on Facebook and Instagram, which doesn't include the 6,000 views of her jumping in the pool. Over 4,000 people visited that single property website, which is the property address right there, right? The property was viewed over 9,000 times on the various websites that she puts it at, Compass, Zillow, Trulia, Realtor, et cetera. 17 qualified and COVID compliant in-person showings, by the way, showed their proof of funds to their lender before being allowed to come to the property, sold the property, right? I forget what she said, how many offers she had on it. Then my memory tells me 10. I could be wrong. But how many of you would like to create that kind of awareness just by a show of hands? Type in yes if you think this is amazing. So guys, I share that with you. Thank you, by the way, for all the comments. I see it. Tracy, John, fabulous. Ruth, yes. It is amazing. And it's also amazingly simple. Is it easy? I don't know if I'd say it's easy, but it's simple. And I say maybe it's not easy per se, quote, easy, because it takes some thought, it takes some planning, and it takes, as I said at the beginning of this, you learning some new skills. Now, you don't have to learn everything. You can outsource running your Facebook ads, right? You, like I said, find a young person to grab a phone and videotape you, right? You may need to learn editing. You could outsource editing to Fiverr or some local young person, right? But the point is, could any of you do this? Really? You could. With just some foresight and thought and just to now know what is the strategy. So once again, the strategy is I've got my organic free content, right? The virtual open house tour. Then I take a snippet of that and then I do an ad. And there's all kinds of other things you can do for paid traffic around that, for retargeting, et cetera. But anyway, I wanted to share with you those three strategies, which is first search, second social, and then third paid traffic. And they all work together as one cohesive system. You guys with me? Okay. Let's wrap this up then and talk about a plan to achieve your goals in 2021. Those goals you just put together, your volume, transactions, all that kind of jazz. This is going to help you get there because the name of the game, we already agreed, more conversations equals more income. Okay? So I want you to take this and you can use it later. Okay? This is my hour of power conversational goal forecast, if you will. This will tell you roughly how many conversations you need to have per day to achieve your transaction goals, okay? Now, what this does here is it assumes that you can anticipate, I'm reading the text here, anticipate one transaction for every 40 business-focused conversations with new leads or database contacts. Results will vary based on your skills. Obviously, if you can get better at qualifying, converting, et cetera, obviously your number will go down. But this is a number that's been used for some time from Tom Ferry and from NAR and people like that. And I'm going to show you an example of this. Now, this assumes we got five prospecting days per week, 50 weeks, 250 days per year. Okay. So let me show you what this looks like. If my goal is 25 transactions, you can see that down in the bottom in red. What that means is if I take my transaction goal, which is 25, I multiply it by 40, I need to have 1,000 conversations in a year. You know, oh my God, sounds like a lot. No, no, let's carry it forward. What's the weekly conversations? 5. So it's my annual quota divided by 50 weeks. That's 5. What's my daily quota? 1. But I want to highlight business-focused conversations. These are people who, right, are in the market or soon to be in the market to buy and sell. Are you with me on this? So how many of you like this? And would you find this useful in calculating what you need to be doing every day and every week? Jessica says, yes, for sure. Jessica's my biggest fan. Thank you, Jessica. I'm a big fan of you. All right. Jessica keeps typing in. Love the giveaway. Love the giveaway. Awesome. So anyway, guys, you're going to have you have a blank copy of this on the slides. You can take here this and do the math yourself. Maybe it's not 25 transactions. Maybe it's 12 or whatever. Okay. But do the math and you'll know exactly how many business focused conversations to have every single week. I hope you find that helpful and useful. When I talk about achieving your goals and it's all about conversations, even though I'm talking about digital domination, I don't want to overlook the keeping the customers you have already, or getting referrals from your past client and sphere of influence. This is just an example. I'm not going to walk you through this for sake of time, but this is an example of kind of like a month at a glance or a week at a glance of activities you might want to do. Make 2 to 4 calls every 6 months or quarterly to your past clients, sphere of influence, people like that, et cetera, et cetera. So you can go back to that and visit that as far as like action items to do. I want to give you a couple other things real quick before we wrap up. Annual goal. Type in your annual goal, 12, 25 transactions, whatever it is, and then this will help you focus in 3 key areas to help achieve that goal. So this is the 3-5-1 plan, right? 3 focus areas, 5 objectives for each focus area to achieve that one goal. What does that look like? 25 transactions, here's my 3 focus areas, here's my 5 objectives. I'm not going to go through it for sake of time. You guys can reference this later. These are just idea stimulators and generators for you. Let's say you know, one of your objectives is, I want to increase my online presence. I want to develop some leads. I want to be better with my SOI, you know, sphere of influence database. Great. These are possibly 5 objectives under each category you could do to focus on those 3 key areas. Are you with me? Is this making sense? You guys finding this valuable? Okay, cool. We got to close out and make time for some Q&A. I'm also going to give you this, by the way, here's how you get the copy of the slides. Anybody want to know? Get with the AmeriFirst loan officer who invited you. They will have a link. They will be able to give you that link so they can give you the slides. And I want you to get with the AmeriFirst loan officer who invited you so they can help you walk through some of these. Your one big idea, such as this, your content marketing plan for 2020 December, this coming month, next month. I'm giving this to you because you have time to implement it, okay? So these are some idea generators on the calendar of what you might want to post, share, et cetera, on your social media platform. You'll have that to walk away with as well. Some more ideas for you here. If you're looking for ideas of content, these are examples of video content, market reports, expert interviews, pro tips, right? Coming soon, just listed, under contract. All these are relevant examples of content that you could and should be posting using this calendar that I showed you. So you can get this. We'll give you a blank copy of it, and then you can just fill in the blanks for your social media posting ideas. Does anybody like that? Can I get a witness, huh? Yeah, see, we're trying to make it easy for you. Give you the map, give you the roadmap. We're here, I told you, we're here to support you. Just remember this, it's all about frequency and showing up. One of the smartest people on the planet, Seth Godin, frequency leads to awareness, awareness to familiarity, and familiarity to trust. And that's what we're going for is trust, because almost without exception, it always leads to profit. And that's the number one thing people look for when choosing a lender or real estate agent is trust first. Yes, above fees, above rates, above commission, all that. Okay. More homework? Yeah. Map out your December content plan like I showed you just from the calendar there. Minimum 3 weeks posting. If you need help with images, get a free Canva account. Those will help you create social media posts and templates. And then, of course, collaborate with your AmeriFirst loan officer. In summary, we talked about the five trends driving digital real estate. We talked about how to just disrupt-proof your business, digital domination. And then we mapped out at least the beginnings of a plan to help you achieve your goals in 2021. More conversations equals more income. And hopefully we'll have a chance to regroup in the coming months of 2021 and dive deeper, which, by the way, take a moment right now. What's the number one focus you want to have for digital in 2021? Is it YouTube? Is it Facebook? Is it Instagram? Google My Business. You tell me what it is. Type it in there right now so we can build these answers. And we got a couple minutes left. Hopefully you got some ideas here today. If so, let us know. I love applause just like you guys. I'm going to turn it back over to our humble hosts. Make sure you get your copy of your book from the loan officer. And if you got any questions right now, we've got a couple of minutes left. Type in your questions and we'll serve them up. But I'll turn it back over to one of our hosts. There we go.
Hey, Geoff, thank you very much. Appreciate it, my friend. Man, that was active. I don't want to become as a fading winner.
Yes.
I need to do more conversations to equal more income. I got to get my daily requirement down exactly, you know, get my annual goal, chunk it down to a daily activity. And I've got to get everybody some links on this.
Right on.
Because everybody's going to want you, want to see this. Ron.
Geoff, can you give me an I feel good, please? That's how I feel after listening to this for the last hour, man. I feel good. I feel good about what we just went through. And you know what? You actually shut me up, which is hard to do. I mean, people will tell you it's hard to shut me up, but I walk away with actually not having any real questions, but I've got pages of execution.
Yes.
Mark, what about you?
You know, it was like drinking from a fire hose with a number of ideas that were there. Just incredible. And I'll tell you what, the one thing that just really resonated with me, because at my age, I see a lot of these people, is the fading successful people. I mean, what a great concept, because there are so many people that were, you know, they were wishing for the old days never coming back. And if they don't dust off their skill set, they are going to be a fading star. No question about it. That was brilliant. It really resonated with me. Great stuff. Thanks so much, Geoff.
Yeah, thank you. I'll be sending the link out to you guys so all the AmeriFirst loan officers can have it, share it with their real estate agents so they can revisit the content and get access to everything we shared.
Yeah. Appreciate it. That was amazing.
If you could hit the applause real quick, I'd love to hear it for you.
Thank you. Thank you to everybody who showed up. And you know, like we said, if you guys want to go deeper on any of these topics, right, we can take one subject and go super deep, like how to do a YouTube channel or Instagram paid ads or whatever it is. So,
all right. So let's get feedback from the group.
Yep.
Guys, get with your loan officers. Let us know what you'd like Geoff to do next. If it's like create your own YouTube channel or whatever the case may be, put it on and let's figure it out.
We got a lot of people putting in like YouTube, Facebook, et cetera. So there's a mix. Well, there you go. All right. People want to know how to do it all, I guess.
Hey, Geoff, I don't think we have to just stop at one, do we?
No. But I like to take one. Okay. Take one, and we got to go deep so they actually get some real progress, you know what I mean, on one particular platform.
Awesome.
All right. Listen, I appreciate it, guys. I guess this is sign off now. Everybody have a happy Thanksgiving.
All right. You too, Geoff.
Good job, Geoff.
All right. Take care.
All right. So yeah, that was that video. I'll transition this over to Ryan. You know, I will say just...
Hello and good morning. It is 10 o'clock Central European Summer Time, and I have the pleasure to welcome you to this...
Hold on one. I'm sorry. I have something in the background. I think...
First quick question, colleague.
Let me get out of there.
If it's... I mean, we are indeed replaying. Oops.
Okay. Sorry, we had a YouTube video playing in the background there. But in any case, yeah, so the things that I loved about that video, just from a social media presence, that's something that our office, our branch, Michelle and I in particular, have really tried to focus on as of late. We were at a Tom Ferry event a couple of weeks ago, and Tom touched on the same items, particularly about videos, doing videos. He said that 81% of consumers actually make a decision after watching a video. So that's how powerful video is. And then also from a Google perspective, just, you know, you'd be surprised at how many lenders, how many real estate agents don't have an actual business Google page. And then having more than 100 images makes it to where it's geotagged in a certain way to where you're easier to find on Google. So just different things like that, that are interesting to kind of help, you know, raise your marketing and presence online, you know, and with YouTube and everything is I think where a lot of people are kind of missing the boat, and very few people have mastered that right now.
Yeah. We've actually had a big realty companies that we work with asking us to do YouTube videos and everything. And we've already have them posted, and AmeriUno, for example, is also doing their own as well. So we're ready. We're ready to move forward. If you guys want to do videos and stuff or game, like whatever you feel.
So Ryan, I'm gonna transfer this back to you. Make sure I do this right here.
That's right. He'll be mad if you
make host.
All right, good. Well, I'm all set. So one of the things before you go, Jace, one of the things that really stood out to me about that was a lot of us, you know, pine for the good old days of when things were easier and they weren't, you didn't have to step outside your comfort zone and be in front of a camera and do all that stuff. You could do things the way you're used to doing them. And one of the things I talked to you guys about the last few weeks is you tell me what you're good at. You tell me, this is how I am. This is what I do, but that's got to change. You've got to evolve if you want to make it. And what you were yesterday is not what you are today. Maybe you were yesterday a procrastinator who didn't like to do videos. Well, today you've got to get in front of the camera and make it happen, or you'll be left behind. Your business will be disrupted. And the guy couldn't have said it better. Jason, our people just absolutely love this stuff. I know they do, because when we train on it, they love it. So let's continue to get them stuff they can use, like the YouTube stuff, the video stuff, the Facebook stuff, all this kind of stuff that that maybe some of our younger folks understand a little better, but they don't know some of the nuances, and some of us older folks don't understand very well at all. So let's get it out there to everybody and do it. And some of our older folks, like Daryl, are doing very well with their Facebook stuff, and so and his newsletters and stuff. So I wanted to share his success on that as well. So, but thank you guys, and we'll see you next week. Do you guys have any mortgage questions for Jason or for Michelle? I put Jason's email in the, Michelle, will you put your email in the chat, please?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
And I know you do it every week, but, or every time you come on, but do it again. And then Jason, do you have the slides from this that you can email these folks if they email you?
Yes. Yes. We can get those slides over. And then I'm still working on the event, the Tom Ferry event a couple weeks ago, getting those slides. Tom was supposed to send them out to the participants, and we haven't got it yet. So I'm still working on those slides. I won't have a video from that because it was an event that he held. But I, you know, definitely would like to get those slides to everybody, because I feel like there's some things on the YouTube and Google and things like that that would obviously be relevant to this too.
Awesome, guys. And like always, we have people who show you how to use stuff, or we show you how to use stuff and how to do stuff. And the only thing that matters is you actually getting out and doing it. So
yeah.
Knowing about it is not good enough. Actually doing it is what matters. So thank you guys for coming. I appreciate it.
Thanks for having
us. And we'll see you next week.
All right.
Okay, thank you. Good.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.
All right, guys. Any kind of questions or comments? Anybody have anything for us today?
Ryan, I have a question.
Yes.
I haven't been on in a couple of weeks because of scheduling conflicts, but a few weeks ago you talked about budgeting for marketing, and a lot of conversation went to what I would call closing gifts, right? Where people were saying how much they spent on closing gifts, which to me is, it's not where the brunt of the marketing dollars need to go. Is there a certain rule of thumb of percentage wise is standard for marketing? I don't know. I'm just kind of trying to get a gauge.
Well, let me tell you something, Rita. Everybody has been told something. And if this were a traditional brokerage where 30% of your money, my answer would be, I don't know, 10%.
Right.
If it's because I can't say 30% because I'm already taking 30%. And then you're figuring I don't have any money to live on. Right. Mm-hmm. So here's the answer for you. And this is the absolute correct answer. I'm not certain of many things in my life, but I'm absolutely certain of this. Every single dollar that you can afford to spend until you're so busy you can't stand it anymore. That's what you should spend on marketing.
Okay.
Every penny you can until you're so busy that you have to hire help. All right. That is the answer. There's no rule of thumb. So, you know, we always talk about our agent success program. We don't take any of your money. We don't give you anything, but we don't take anything. We don't take any of your money. Spend that money on your business, whatever money you think you can spend and still survive. And I don't care what kind of business you're starting. Don't get me started on this, because there's photos of Jeff Bezos working out of his garage with a funny looking hat that we all used to wear back in the whatever year that was. And he's got a paper printed out thing of Amazon.com hanging on his wall. And he's spending every penny he can on growing his business. And it worked out pretty well for him. But you can see that he started, there's a picture online of his garage that he started out of, a very average looking house and every average looking garage that he started out of. You spend every penny you can while you're growing a business. I don't care if you've got a hot dog stand or Amazon.com, you spend every penny you can starting.
Right.
So there is no rule of thumb. You're absolutely right. I mean, closing gifts are, we talked a lot about closing. We talked a disproportionate amount of time on closing gifts, but you know, people are, that's something that's interesting and people try to be unique and that kind of thing. So I get why people talk about it so much. It's more fun to talk about than digital ads. But digital ads and stuff are much more important.
Right. Okay.
But what the guy was saying today, engagement with all these people, engagement with all these things, get engaged with everything. You have to play the game or you're going to lose. If you don't play, you're definitely going to lose. It's like the lottery. All right.
Okay.
But accept that if you play, the harder you play, the more you're going to win, not like the lottery. So you've got to get out and do it. Okay.
Yes. That makes sense. Thank you.
I hope that non-answer answers your question, because
it does.
Every penny, the answer is that. So, but when you go to certain brokerages and stuff, they'll tell you, oh, 10% is fine, because they can't tell you the truth. Or you'll get depressed and quit. All right.
Right. Completely understandable. Thank you. Okay.
I'm all in this to depress you guys. So let me know what you need. Any other questions? Guys, I just try to be real with you, because there's no reason to fake stuff and let you guys, you know, what do they call it? Well, you're just fading in the wind as your money disappears and all your time disappears. And then you're nowhere, you're no further down the line to where you need to be. So what I want to do with you guys is be straightforward and let you guys know what it takes to succeed. To the best of my knowledge, some of you guys do other things and you do great. So, but I just want to be straightforward with you guys, because there's no reason to sugarcoat it. You've got to spend money to make it in this business. You've got to spend time and money, and you got to work. So get out there and do it. And sitting here and telling you all these things or watching videos and all that stuff, that's not going to make you successful until you get out and actually implement, execute what you're learning. Okay. Any questions?
Not really a question, but something I really got from the video, and I was actually paying attention sometimes to it. Asking for your lender and your title company for a Google review for yourself. I usually only ask my buyers and my sellers. So I get a lot, but I don't get enough that I need. And I've worked with some really good lenders that I usually don't use, because I have normal lenders that I use all the time. But I've worked with some others that have gave me really good service. Same with title companies. I've worked with some really bad ones, but I would definitely give reviews on some of the good ones that I've worked with. Actually, I just worked with a really good one. It was an attorney in Winter Park that I've never worked with him before. And he was great. He came out to the house yesterday to close. Because my buyers were coming from, where are they coming from? Washington State.
They flew in and they didn't want to go to Winter Park. So we met at the house to close. But that's like a perfect opportunity for the lender and the title company for reviews for yourself. You know, give them reviews and then that's two more reviews for you. So that's what awesome. I got out of it today. You always awesome. Take something from something.
Yeah, a couple of comments there. All the way from Washington State, but they're like, nah, Winter Park's too far. Yes, guys, whether you are doing the kind of business that Daryl is doing or you're just starting or whatever, people want your business. Leverage yourself as a realtor. Do you know, like, these magazines, these Orlando Mastermind, all these magazines and all this kind of stuff, all the sponsors, the way they make money is all of these people, title companies, everybody, lenders, title companies, all these people, warranty companies, everybody wants you because you're the linchpin of a real estate operation of the sale. They want you to send them business. And so everybody kisses up to you. You guys know that, right? Lenders, guys, exploit that. You know what? If I'm sending a lender, you know, three people a month, send me somebody back once in a while, or I'll find another lender. Somebody should be referring people back to you. Leverage yourselves. You want reviews? Absolutely, Daryl. I hadn't even thought of reviews. I don't care if you want a turkey sandwich. Talk to a lender. You know what I mean? These people, they want your business. Ask them for stuff. Quit just handing them stuff. Ask them for stuff. Title companies, lenders, whomever you're referring people to or helping people out with. Even photographers might be of use to you. Hey, if somebody calls you for pictures in your house and they're thinking about selling it, some people might call photographers first. Probably 1 out of 100 people says, you know what? I got to get pictures of my house. I might put it on Zillow or something. And now you know of a marketing, you know of something coming before anybody else. Have them, you know, hey, nobody else is asking them for their business, I bet. All kinds of attorneys, ask them for stuff when they get it. You know, an attorney is going to have a title company's sometime they're going to have, because of the attorney, you're going to have people, they're going to know about sales coming up before anybody else does. You know, I've told you guys a million times about, well, that's an exaggeration, 100 times about divorce attorneys, probate attorneys, all these people that you're going to be referring people to a probate attorney at some point in your career if you haven't already. And you need to get that stuff. You need to get stuff back from them, but create relationships, not so much with a divorce attorney is a different thing because you can't leverage anything there, but you guys talk to divorce attorneys, try to create a friendship with them, a relationship with them. So anyway, sorry, Daryl, I'm going off point, but you need to leverage these things. You guys have a lot of leverage. If you want co-marketing stuff, if you want anything, you want them to co-sponsor your first time home buyer seminar, anything that you want to do, talk to these people. They want your business. They're going to cooperate with you. And certainly for something like a review, that's actually great. They can have everybody in their office write your review. You know, get some good reviews out there. All right. Great point, Daryl. Anybody else have anything?
I have a question about that as well, Ryan. Regarding reviews for the buyers, I've been trying to focus on Zillow reviews. So for buyer purposes, is it better to get Zillow reviews or Google reviews? Can you transfer from one to the other? No.
You can't transfer, but they can leave you one here and one there. I mean, they can leave, you can't like copy and paste it. No, but it's going to come from
your computer. Not copy and paste. What I mean is, can you share that review without touching it? Of course. Is there a way that company can share that somewhere else?
No, but you can have them leave you a review on both? Google and on Zillow. Yeah. I mean, for them, it's copy and pasting, you know, mm-hmm. I mean, it's not that big of a deal for them. I would send them links to each one and have them leave you a review of both.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
But get these other ones too, Malvis. You send people to title companies and lenders and everything else. Do that. And guys, if you're sending any amount of any reasonable amount of business to a lender or a title company, well, not a title company, but a lender, they should be sending you business back. Okay. If not, there's a bunch more lenders out there. All right.
Ryan, not just lenders, I think insurance companies, you know, we refer people to them all the time as well.
Okay. Yep.
I would add that to the list.
Well, yeah, you're right. Lenders are, I would add that to the list too. They're also kissing up to us all the time. But the, but lenders are going to have guys, people, a lot of times their first call is to a lender.
Right.
They want to see what they can get pre-qualified for. And lenders are out there marketing, so they get stuff.
Right.
All right. But if they're giving it all to their brother-in-law and you're sending them five deals a month, then that's an unequal relationship and you can find a more equal one.
Exactly.
And the leads are not just from lenders and title companies either. I've had leads from my dry cleaner. I use Acme dry cleaners in downtown, you know, Robinson and Magnolia, right there by the View. They're good friends of mine now. I've used them for years. They have a drive-through. Crystal is one of the owners, and I know her. I love her. And they've sent me quite a few customers. Actually, I send new customers in there, and they get, I think, $10 off their first dry cleaning, which I announced on my Facebook a couple of years ago.
Awesome. Works great. Awesome. So yeah. So he gave you the directions, guys. Go down there and talk to that dry cleaner and try to get their leads instead of him giving them to Daryl. Good idea, everybody.
Tell them downtown Daryl sent you. You get $10 off your first dry cleaning.
Okay. All right, guys. Any other questions or comments? Awesome. All right. Well, we'll see you next week. Do you guys like this today? This, to me, this is valuable information. This is good stuff. I love the more technical stuff. I know you guys learn a lot from that. So I love that. And I like to understand this stuff. And again, Abby is there to help you as well. Abby knows all this kind of stuff. So be sure to get with her if you have any questions. And tomorrow's Abby's birthday. So happy birthday, Abby. Yep. She'll be 17 tomorrow. So we're very excited for her.
Happy birthday.
I'm kidding. She just looks like it. All right, guys. Well, have a great day, and we'll see you next week. And go get them. Execute. Bye, guys.